Hey guys, welcome back. I'm so excited about today's video because I am going to play with all of these goodies right here. This is the new GlamLite collection, the Ice Cream Dream collection. I picked up the entire collection. So if you'd like to hear my thoughts on these products, see how they apply, stick around. We're going to get started in just a moment. Before we do, if you're new here, hi, I'm Annie. I'm a 40-something lover of color who believes you can have fun with color at any age. If that sounds fun or interesting, if you love colorful makeup and indie makeup as much as I do, as much as I know all my subscribers here do, I would love it if you would join us by subscribing down below. Please keep in mind, I am not a trained makeup artist. I am just someone who really, really loves to play with and talk about makeup, especially when it's indie, and has exactly one person in her life who's at all willing to listen to her. So I'm here. All right, before we get started, you may hear some humming in the background, especially if you have headphones on. It is once again ridiculously hot where I am, so I have the fan on in order to survive. Otherwise, I will just be a melted puddle and it will not be good. So there's that. I will do my best when I get it into my editing software to kind of reduce that hum. Also, if it looks like I have been wearing my makeup for a while and it looks a little bit like a mess, it is. I did film another video before this and I am lazy. I didn't want to take off my entire makeup and start again. So I just took off my eye makeup, reapplied some concealer and called it good. I do have some staining here from the products that I had on earlier, so there's that. If you're curious, it is the new Kaleidos makeup collection, and that staining is from the Violet palette. Okay, all of that stuff is out of the way. Let's kind of go into what I have here, which is a lot, because like I said, I did pick up the entire collection, including the lashes. Don't ask me why. If you've been here at all, you will know that lashes are not my thing. If I try to put them on, they wind up all over my face in strange places where they don't belong. But it did come with three pairs of lashes, the ice cream sandwich lashes, which look like this. The chocolate taco lashes, I used to love chocolate tacos, which look like this. And the ice cream cookie sandwich, which is freaking adorable, that look like this. So I will obviously not be playing with these today. I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do with these lashes, but for now they're going to go over there and we are just going to play with the rest of the things. Let's talk first about the little ice cream cones right here. So these are all little lip glosses in here. I'm just going to kind of read from the website. So if I'm looking over here, that is what I am doing. Let's start with Caramel, which is this one here. I mean, hi, is this not the cutest packaging you have ever seen in your life? So this is just a kind of, I guess, caramel colored gloss. It looks like this. Super, super cute. It does have a little mirror on the tube and it's supposed to smell like caramel. So I'm going to smell that and let's see. Ooh, it does. It smells like caramel. Let's go ahead and swatch it just to see kind of how opaque it is. If I can do a decent swatch. That is actually pretty nice. I'm excited about that color. That's really nice. Terrible swatch. Lovely. If these are anything like the glosses that I got in my foodie box that were like the taco themed, I will be thrilled. So that's the caramel gloss. And then next up, let's kind of put that back in its package and set that aside. Next up is going to be the strawberry gloss. Again, this is super cute packaging. And the strawberry gloss is, I would imagine, is going to smell like strawberries. Here's what it looks like. So, so cute. And yes, it's supposed to be scented like strawberry. Definitely has a strawberry scent to it. And then we'll go ahead and swatch it. Again, very opaque. Here it is right here. That's a really nice shade. I'm very excited about that. Very, very nice. And then the last one is the cookies and cream, which looks like this. It reminds me a bit of the diamond balm from Fenty Beauty. Oh, what have I done? Ack, come back. Sorry, my iPad got a little out of hand here. So yeah, like I said, this is the cookies and cream gloss, and this is supposed to be cookies and cream scented. Ooh, yeah, that smells good. And then we'll just go ahead and swatch it, though I don't think we're gonna see much. And yeah, it's just a clear, sparkly gloss there. So I'm super excited about these. I really, really enjoyed the formula from the two glosses I already have from them. So I'm really excited about these ones and trying them out. Continuing on the lip product theme, we have these two sets here. This is the chocolate popsicle set here, and this is the strawberry popsicle lip set. So let's look at the chocolate popsicle set first. This consists of a chocolate chip. Let's see if they're in order here. Ooh, let's get them out. But did I show you the inside of this? I swear, what's wrong with me today? This is what they look like. And I think this one over here is going to be chocolate chip. I just kind of have to pull them out, which is a little difficult. Okay, yes. So this is chocolate chip, which is a high shine cream color nude lip gloss. I can't tell if they're scented or not. I don't think so. Here is chocolate chip swatched. I'm going to wind up with some really strange swatches. I know, I'm sorry. Next up in this is Sweet Fudge, which is the sparkly, sparkly nude lip gloss. So it looks like that. Let's swatch it. Here it is, well, here on my wrist. That one does smell like chocolate. The other one didn't really smell like chocolate. It smelled a little weird, honestly. I don't know about that one. And then the last one in this set is Chocolate. Chocolate is a luxurious chocolate matte liquid lipstick. I have never tried their liquid lipstick formula, so I'm excited about that. Ooh, that is a beautiful shade. That is lovely. And again, that one does smell, it smells a little bit like a mocha, honestly. It's got a little bit of a coffee hint to my nose anyways, but my nose could be wrong. All right, moving on to the strawberry popsicle after I get this out of my way. Here's the strawberry popsicle, and here is what it looks like inside. Those are the shades. Again, super, super cute. We are going to start with this shade here. Let's see. The first shade is Strawberry Sherbet, which is an ultra dazzling berry gloss, ooh, which I think is this one. Here it is. So it's one of the sparkly glosses. Let's see, where am I going to swatch this? I guess I'm going to swatch it over here. It smells nice. So here it is right here. That is really pretty. I love that these glosses are pretty opaque, and I feel like I could really wear them on their own, which makes me very happy. Next up is Strawberry Shortcake, which is this shade here. This is a high shine pink lip gloss, so no sparkle in this one. Again, oh, that smells really good, like strawberries. And I would say this is more like a peachy color right here. I don't know how well you can see that, but there it is right there. That's really nice. But I would definitely say that's more peach than pink. And last but not least in this set, we have Berrylicious, which is a rich magenta matte liquid lipstick. Again, it has that lovely strawberry scent. Oh yes. Wait till you see this. This is bright. That is amazing. So there are all of the lip products swatched out. They are so pretty, and I think they kind of fulfill my need to purchase lip products for a while. So excited. I can't wait to put one of these on my lips. Okay, so now it is time to see the big star of this collection, which is this adorable thing right here. This is the Ice Cream Dream palette itself. It is 30 shades of awesomeness. I got mine in the limited edition PR box, and it's so cute. I mean, this is right up there with the birthday, or the, what is it called? the cake palette. But I don't know what's wrong with me. Here again is the outer packaging. You open up the truck and the palette is inside. It is so, so cute. Let's go ahead and take this out so you can see it. So adorable. Here it is. Here's the outer packaging for the palette. This is so such a cute little touch. The cone on the front is like shiny, and then the sprinkles move around inside. So, so, so cute. I absolutely love it. So, so excited. This is just absolutely gorgeous. There are so many choices that I'm just honestly not sure what to do. I'm so, so excited about this. Of course, GlamLite is a cruelty-free brand, so if that's important to you, it is also important to them. I always love that about GlamLite. This was quite expensive for the entire collection. I'm trying to remember exactly how much I paid. Oh yes, it was $149 for the whole collection, which was cheaper than buying it separately. Again, it did come with the lashes. I will not be using the lashes, but there's that. All right, I think that's all I have to say about this right now. I will go ahead and insert some swatches, and then we will move right into the look. Okay, so I think I have a plan today. You would think, knowing me, that I would go in with the pinks and that lime green, but I'm not going to, because I actually have a video that I want to film with this tomorrow, and I kind of want to use those shades tomorrow for that video. So I'm going to do something a little bit different. I think I'm going to start with this shade up here, Mango, and then go in with Strawberry Cheesecake, I think, followed by Red Velvet and Black Cherry. Maybe, and then we'll see about the lid. So we are going to start with that. I am going to start again, like I said, with Mango, which is that yellow shade. I'm going to pick that up on a Luxie 229 tapered blending brush. And I'm going to pop that here. Hopefully this, well, I have some pink staining there, which really is kind of a bummer, but it is what it is. Okay, that is a beautiful yellow. I don't know if you can see just how pigmented that is. I can in real life. That is so, so good. So good. I do wish I didn't have that staining there though. Ugh. But I'm going to go in with some kind of pinker tones anyway, so that should actually be okay. That yellow is gorgeous, laid down beautifully, so pigmented. Holy cow. Holy cow. Next up, we are going to go in with, I think, like I said, the shade Orange Cream, which is this shade right here. I'm just going to pick that up on my Luxie 231 small tapered blending brush, and we are just going to kind of apply that next to and a little bit into that yellow. Again, beautifully pigmented shadow, really applying very, very nicely. There is some kick up in the pan, but nothing too major. That is so pretty. Oh my gosh, I love that so much. Holy cow, what a beautiful shade. Again, it applied beautifully with very little effort and blended in so nicely to that yellow. I am just going to go back in with that first brush, no additional product, and just kind of blend where those two meet, just to be sure that it's exactly seamless the way I want it. Wow, super, super pretty. Okay, so next up, we are going to go in with, I think, the shade Red Velvet, which is going to be this shade right here. I think I'm just going to continue using that small tapered blending brush. I'm just going to kind of clean it off on my, if I can get it to hold still, clean it off on my color switcher here. And then we're going to go into Red Velvet and apply that next to Orange Cream. Again, that is absolutely lovely. I'm going to kind of drag this one out a bit. My eyebrow over here got way out of hand. Holy cow, what happened there? That is super pretty too. And I think I'm going to go ahead and pull that down here as well. Wow, I'm so happy with the way that applied. That is absolutely gorgeous. I'm going to go back in with a little bit more of orange cream and just kind of add that in here. And then I'm going to go in with a clean brush and I'm just going to blend out this edge. These shadows are beautiful and really are performing exactly as I would hope and expect. So, so pretty. All right, now I'm going to go into the shade Black Cherry using my Luxie 213, which is an eye shading brush. So that is this super bright kind of fuchsia shade here. And I'm just going to pop that here on the outer corner. Oh gosh, that's gorgeous. And blend it into what I've already got. I'm also going to drag this down a bit under my lashes. So beautiful. Now picking up a little bit more of Red Velvet, I'm just going to blend here in the outer corner just a little bit more. I am so happy with these shadows so far, you guys. These are beautiful, and I really, really do love the blend that I'm getting here, despite, again, like I had that staining, which really is annoying. But at this point, it is what it is. I'm just going to add a little bit more of that orange cream shade just to kind of bring that back. And then let's go ahead and I'm going to add those same shades under my lashes. Just going to speed through that because I think you guys probably get the picture. Same exact shades. Alrighty then, it is time for the shimmers. So of course, first we are going to apply some NYX Glitter Primer because I always, always use NYX Glitter Primer. We all know this by now. And I think, I guess it all depends on what shades I decide I'm gonna use because I'm still kind of ruminating on that one. I'm going to pop that here on my lid. And we're gonna go ahead and kind of create a cut crease shape. And then I think starting with the lightest shade that I want to use, which I think is going to be Pecan Pie, which is this shade right here. I am going to pick that up on my brush and I am just going to place it here. Wow, that is beautiful. That is a really interesting shade. It has got all kinds of shiftiness to it. I see like little purple speckles and pink speckles. I mean, it looks very just kind of boring, kind of bronze in the pan. But when you get this like on, oh my heavens, that is so beautiful. Holy cow. That is gorgeous. Now I think what I'm going to do is go into the shade Tarot, which is this purple shade right here. This one is not quite as sparkly. I did swatch it a little bit to decide what I was going to use. And I would say this one is definitely not quite as sparkly as the other. It's a little more on the satin side. I wouldn't call it a true satin, but it's not that amazing sparkly metallic that the Pecan Praline was. Then I'm just gonna kind of go back and forth between these two sides of my brush to make sure that's blended. And then we're going to pick up a little bit more of Black Cherry, which is that bright fuchsia shade. And we're gonna kind of tap it in here to the outer corner to make sure this is all blended. I don't know, I wish I would have used a different color than that purple. There's nothing wrong with the purple. I just don't love it as much as I love the other. It is what it is now. It's there. There's nothing I can do about it. For my inner corner, I think for my inner corner, I am going to go in with maybe the shade Salted Caramel. Maybe we'll try that one. I'm just going to pick that up on a little pencil brush. This one just happens to be from BH Cosmetics. Maybe we'll see how this goes. And pop it here in the inner corner. This seems to be, I haven't swatched this shade yet. It seems to be a little one of those kind of ones that like moves around a bit in the pan. A little more emollient, I guess. It's a little darker than I was going for. Let's go in with French Vanilla, which is this shade here. I'm sorry, this is Salted Caramel. I forgot to show you that. This is French Vanilla. We're gonna go ahead and pick up a little bit of that, I think, just to kind of brighten this up a bit. Wow, that is definitely bright. All right, so here is where I am so far. I'm gonna go ahead and catch this eye up, add my eyeliner, all of that stuff, and then I will come back and we'll add some lipstick. I haven't decided which shade I'm gonna use. I might use that fuchsia because it is gorgeous. Might be a little over the top, but who cares at this point? Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead, catch all that stuff up, again, add my liner, those things, and then I will be back to do lip gloss and lipstick and show you the finished look. Okay, so now that the eyes are done, we have to think about lips, and I have, my choices are a little bit overwhelming. I could go like totally nude with this chocolate popsicle stick. I could go bright pink, or again, I can go kind of nuder naturally with these adorable little ice cream cone glosses. So a lot of different directions I can go in. I think what I am going to do is I am going to try out one of their the liquid lipsticks because I haven't tried this formula before. So I think I'm going to go in with this crazy bright pink. And again, I know it's crazy and bright and may just be a little bit out of control, but we are gonna go for it. Ooh, and I'm gonna drop all the things. All right, so this is again the shade Berrylicious. Just as a refresher, this is how bright it is. It is insane. It does have a nice strawberry smell to it, which I really, really like. And then let's, I guess, just go ahead and apply it. So here is what the lipstick looks like. This is a very thin formula, and it does feel a bit drying, so I'm not sure that this is going to be my favorite formula. I do get the feeling that this is going to be very transfer proof. So if you're looking for something that is going to withstand a mask, these might work for you. However, you do have to be okay with your lips feeling a bit dry, because like I said, it does feel very, very dry on my lips. And I would say that definitely dried down. I do have a little bit of transfer, but I think that's just from the parts that hadn't quite dried down yet. So again, yeah, this is going to be probably very, very transfer proof. So if that's important to you, you might like this formula as long as you don't mind that kind of drying feel on your lips. I'm not a huge fan of that feeling myself. That's just personal preference, but this is what it is so far. Yeah, I mean, I can rub my lip there and you can see it doesn't come off on my finger. That is very transfer proof. So like I said, this is great for mask wearing. Do I wanna pop a gloss over the top? I think I'm just gonna leave it like this. I do know that I love GlamLite's gloss formula. So I'm definitely gonna be playing with all of these products to really form my opinion some more on them. But for now, I think I'm just gonna leave the lip the way it is. So here is everything. Here is the final look. Okay, so let's talk about the products that I did use today, starting, I guess, with the lipstick. So again, I think that the lipstick is a gorgeous shade. It is not the most comfortable, in my opinion. But I do like that it is transfer-proof, so again, if you're going someplace and you need to make sure that your lipstick is going to be on for one reason or another, this is definitely a formula that you might look into. It is very, very lightweight, but again, it is quite drying on my lips. However, if you're going to be taking your mask off and you want to have lipstick, that's your girl right there. Obviously, I didn't use anything from the chocolate popsicle today, but I will get there. That will happen. So there are the lipsticks. The lip glosses, I didn't use the lip glosses today. The packaging is so cute. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. I love how opaque the swatches were. I think that that is fantastic. That makes me like super, super happy. I'm really kind of a gloss girl these days. I really, really do enjoy them. So hopefully these will be some that I can get some use out of, even with my masks. I do know that I do like GlamLite's formula when it comes to glosses. As far as the palette, I still can't get over how cute this ice cream truck is. I am so in love with it. I think it is so cute. And then, I mean, come on. These little sprinkles, you have got to be kidding me. You've just got to be kidding me. It's too cute. You know I'm a sucker for cute packaging, and this is everything that I love in packaging. And the color story is to die for. This is so beautiful. All of the shades that I used today, so I used 1, 2, 3, 4 matte shades and 1, 2, 3, 4 shimmer shades. They were all fantastic. This one, I will say, Tarot, was the weakest of the shades that I used today. Just because it's a bit of a drier formula, and it's not that ultra metallic shimmer that I like. It's definitely more of a satiny kind of shimmer, as you can kind of see on my hand there. But Pecan Praline, oh my gosh, this shade is incredibly beautiful. Here it is on my finger, if that will focus. Put my palette down. Focus. There it is on my finger, and it really doesn't look like much, but oh my gosh. And I don't know that the camera will even pick this up. There are some sparkles in here that are like pink and green and gold, and it is just so, so interesting in real life. It is beautiful, and it looks absolutely stunning on the lid. I am really, really, really happy with that shade. I really love it. I cannot wait to play more with this palette. Like I said before, I do have plans to film with this tomorrow as well. I have a very, very fun video that I want to do. It's actually a tag video, but I'm going to do it while playing with makeup. So I'm really excited about that. I'm going to use this palette to do it. So look for that. That should be up on Monday. This should be going up Sunday. So there's that. So you'll get two videos in a row on this palette. And then I do plan on doing a lot more looks with this. Please let me know down below what you'd like to see. Do you want to see like a one palette kind of three looks video, if I can squeeze that into a formula, to a smaller format? Do you want to see me kind of compare this to the cake palette? Because that could happen too. I think that there are some shades that are a little bit similar. So if you wanted to see that, please let me know down below. And I think that is all I have to say, other than I am so happy that I picked this collection up. I think it's gorgeous. It is so, so pretty. These lashes, I mean, the packaging is so cute. I couldn't help myself. I don't know what's going to happen to them. They will probably wind up in a giveaway or something like that. But yeah, super, super cute collection. So adorable. I will leave all of the information down below. Not all of the pieces are currently available on the website. I think that they do plan on restocking, so do keep an eye on that. But I will go ahead and link everything down below if you're interested in checking them out or picking them up. And yeah, I think that's everything. So thank you guys so much for watching today. If you liked today's video, please don't forget to hit that like button down below. And if you're not already, scooch on over, hit subscribe. Next to subscribe is that little bell. If you ring that bell, you should be notified of all of my uploads. And of course, you can also find me on Instagram at seemybliss_beauty. If you leave your house today, please don't forget to wear your mask, wash your hands, be kind to your friends, be kind to your neighbors, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.